which I think was inspired.
I see.
When we came back to impose by vote,
yes,
secret voting, voting.
Okay.
The boy got the 10 votes.
Wow. Interesting.
And yesterday, a good priest. Well, you say we are making too much, we are putting too much importance on academic.
Academic. Which is not enough.
Yes. So I told this layman, it's a difficult thing for me to decide to recommend a student to his bishop to withdraw him from the seminary. It is a problem also to promote,
yes,
the student. In two cases, you can make a mistake.
Okay.
Promote someone who should not be.
Okay.
Or
stop somebody who should be.
Should be. You see the point?
I get the point.
Yeah, it's a human decision.
So according to you, what can you say regarding Fonlon's case?
Fonlon's case, well, I always told students, do not decide to leave on your own. But when you are asked to go away, go away happily. But if you decide on your own, you will be blaming yourself in the future.
Okay.
That maybe did something with me because I decided not to listen to God.
Okay. I see.
Expose yourself spiritually to your spiritual director. If your advice is so, you need to go away. It is not your problem.
Go away. Happily.
If he is making a mistake, it's not your problem.
Okay. Quite interesting.
Yes, don't want to be a priest by force.
At all costs.
No, at all costs, no.
Okay.
That's the advice I give you, is, you know, you come from there, you want to go there, you say no. Be open to your spiritual director. If he advises you to go, go. And sing hallelujah.
Okay.
Hey, I have the vocation. You have to be judged. Somebody else has to say, you have the vocation.
It's not your guide.
It's not, right.
Not a guide.
It's not right. It's not right.
Okay. That's quite interesting.
Yeah.
But from what I read, Fonlon left happily and continued with his life. In fact, the reformators were impressed.
Yes.
He played the piano at the ordination of his classmates.
Classmates, yes.
And served at mass,
yes,
of his classmates, and the formators were impressed and they gave him scholarship to Ireland.
And he was always so welcoming to us, to priests.
I see, in Yaoundé.
In Yaoundé.
Ah. So you met him in Yaoundé after?
Oh, yes, when I was a preacher, when I was a bishop already, there I met him. And he came to see me.
Bishop of Yaoundé.
Now, Garwa.
Oh, Garwa. Archbishop.
Archbishop.
Okay.
He came to see me.
I see.
And he was looking at me, shaking his head. Sean.
He could not believe it.
I wonder if you were living, what would you say when I became a cardinal? He was dead.
Oh, my God. He should have written a book about you.
Yes, he would have.
So, it's evident, before we go to Garwa, he wrote an open letter to the bishops of Boya and Bamenda.
On the seminary?
On the seminary, 1973.
Yes.
And you were rector at that time?
Yes.
What was your reaction to the letter?
I wrote.
Yeah.
He has a pinch, how would I put it? He had a weak point for communism.
Okay.
Yes.
I see.
There were some communist ideas in what he wrote.
He wrote.
So I reacted.
To those points.
Yes.
But apart from those points, was it a positive letter in terms of how it should be on the scholar, especially that point?
Yes, he insisted much on the scholar.
Yes.
He came to the major seminary in Bambui.
Okay.
And I was there, he went to the library.
Interesting.
He saw the dissertations of the first students in Bambui and others. And he said, wow. This in Yaoundé will be dissertations for the masters.
Wow.
Students who were doing the master's degree.
He was impressed.
Very impressed.
Wow. Very impressed. Was that before he got the letter or after?
Scientifically, no, after he had written the letter, years after he had
written the open letter. Okay, so scientific investigation was well done.
Yes, yes, yes. Scientific. If you go to Bambui today, the dissertations, the guys produced today are even better stuff.
Wow.
Very interesting.
So the point on the...
And the ex-students.
Yes.
There was an ex-student that he had the seminary.
Yes.
And went to Amadibelo University in Nigeria.
I see.
And the rector there wrote to me, the boy must have given us the Juden Kai, it was called. Very brilliant boy.
Okay.
From Bekunyam. And Bekunyam is on the top of the parish.
Oh my God, very far away.
Find the thick bush, you know.
Interesting.
He, what this boy was good at philosophy.
Wow.
When you were teaching him,
yes,
he'd be looking at you.
Hmm.
Once he, as long as he has not understood, he will not write.
Okay.
When he looks at you, when you see him writing them,
yes,
he has got the point.
Interesting.
Yes.
So you were his teacher?
Yes,
you
I taught
philosophy.
I taught him metaphysics.
After having graduated with a doctorate degree from Freiburg.
From Freiburg.
Interesting.
Yes.
How were your experiences in Freiburg at the time? As a black priest studying in Freiburg in those days, the language I think was... No, you have studied French already.
Yes, I came from France already.
Okay.
A degree in philosophy and
theology. Interesting.
I did only a doctorate in French.
Okay.
I wanted to write something on that time, on Africa for thinking.
I see.
And my professor said, no, he cannot direct me because he doesn't know anything about African thinking.
Thank you.
If he choose that point, he was honest, if he choose that point, I'll have to recommend you to Freiburg, in Switzerland.
Intellectual honesty.
In Germany.
In Germany.
Yes. But he cannot direct me.
He was very clear about that,
yes.
Honest.
Then he proposed that I do something European and when I come back.
Right.
Well, right, what I think. And that's what he did. My thesis was on the British people who are not metaphysicians, but they use metaphysics in their philosophical thinking.
Okay.
So that was what I went to do. British pragmatist, British philosophers don't study much metaphysics, but they use it. So that's why I was, and unconsciously they use metaphysics. So I'm not sure the same movement on them.
Well,
I think I wrote Manya Cum Laude.
Wow, congratulations. Manya Cum Laude. I see. So then you were approached by Bishop Awa to come back and, in fact, he nominated you already or he asked your opinion and be the rector?
Bishop Awa and Bishop Paul.
Oh, both of them?
They were the two bishops.
Okay.
My bishop was Bishop Paul.
I see, Paul the Jacob.
Yes. Because when Bamena was created, we were asked to choose.
I see.
To remain in Buya
or to go to
Bamenda, the priest.
I see.
Well, I said to myself, I would like to be with somebody who knows me very well.
Exactly.
And Bishop Paul knew me than I know myself.
Interesting.
Yes, my best curriculum vitae was written by Bishop Paul. Certain things I never knew about me.
Okay.
He knew.
Wow.
Was he there? Never knew my book. Of course, we were together. We were in primary school
together.
And she sang. He was ahead of me.
Okay.
Because those of them who grew up in Chisholm didn't go to Manipula school. I knew Lantro better than Bishop Paul.
Okay.
When he came from Rome, he couldn't speak Lantro either.
Yeah, forgot it.
Yeah, because he didn't learn much of it.
Okay.
Maybe we did 3 years. And we did 11 years of primary school.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. 3 years in the village in the language.
Yes.
And school. It was 8 years now.
Okay.
Yeah. I see. So that is as concerning Fonlon and his people. The other did not. They were convinced they were doing the right thing.
Exactly.
Because you are taking the decision before God.
That's true.
It's God who is calling. If you are not careful, you come down against the calling of God.
Okay.
And I tell students, it's not your problem. If you are asked to go away.
If you pull on the person who sent you away.
Voila.
Okay. Go away happily.
Yeah.
Don't have grudges.
No.
Because many seminarians, ex-seminarians have grudges.
Because you do not know why God allowed you to live that experience of the seminary. You know?
Okay.
It can never be useless.
Never.
The experience of a seminary. In America, I hear quite a number of those who support the church. Financially today in America are ex-seminarians. And who, their children are priests.
Okay. So it's a very positive thing.
Yeah.
Going through the moral, the spiritual formation, the pastoral formation.
Why did God allow you to go through all that?
Uh-huh.
God control is the one directing us.
Okay. You just have to follow him.
Yes. You know, I tell people, you know, nobody dies without God wanting him or her to die. No. Because God decided alone that you come on earth to create you.
That's true.
And you came alone. You go out alone. When you one dies, it's a sign that the work for which God created him on earth has been done.
Has been accomplished.
And you go away and give place for another person.
Yes, sir.
Don't try to look for scapegoats and say, it's this one who did this, this one who did.
Okay, not good. That's a very, very important point, especially when somebody dies, people begin to say, this is the person who did this and that, and
decisions and families. That's looking at life.
They're not looking at that with a lens of faith.
No.
In resurrection.
A Christian, you say, God, some die young, some die old. God knows why.
Okay.
Maybe he keeps us who are older to truly be converted. You know that those who die, there's a saying that those who die young are loved by God.
Okay.
Those who God vows, yes, die young.
I see. Interesting.
The same.
I see. So, the point on Fonlon accepting the God's decision in his life through the rector?
I have never heard him blame anybody.
Okay, ever since you knew him?
Yes. Because he always admired his studies. And he told us, one word now, at a mature age with him.
Okay.
That he didn't learn anything new when he went to Ireland.
I see.
To do degrees.
Oh, nothing new?
Nothing new.
So where did he learn that from the seminar? Interesting.
Anybody who comes out from a major seminary in Bangalore to the university, goes to the university, scientific meteorology, that they do it today in the seminary.
Yes.
How to do a research. They have produced scientific dissertations.
Yes.
Directed by degree holders. There's nobody teaching the seminary today who has no degree.
That's true.
But in our time, some priests who were teaching us had only learned theology in the seminary.
Philosophy.
Yes.
They are not gone out to do
lessons. No. In Enugu, there was only one person who had done a master in philosophy.
Oh.
All the others who were teachers, they had only learned philosophy in the seminary.
I see. Quite
but today, you go to Enugu where we study.
A bigger?
Bigger Memorial, there are at least 50 doctorate holders.
So many, almost all of them.
Oh, I was... No, every one of them.
Okay.
Today you are not allowed to teach in the seminary, you don't have at least a licentiate degree in the subject you are teaching.
Okay. I visited Bigard and I was very excited to see a picture in the refectory.
Yes. The refectory?
Yes, the refectory of the formators.
Because we love meeting. Yes, yes. I was never a formator in Bigard.
But I think your picture is there because you're an ex-student of Bigard.
Yeah.
You studied there and the picture is there. In fact, your picture is just close to that of Cardinal Aguinze.
Yes, maybe they put those who have been bishops.
Yes, archbishops and cardinals.
Yes.
So they were so happy to know that I was coming from the Cameroons. And they said, when you go back, please.
Many of us went through there.
Okay. Cardinal Paul Vetekov, too, Archbishop Paul Vetekov.
Yes. Okay. Our. Mm-hmm. Bishop Paul Vetekov were in the same class.
Okay. So why would you think the bishops were sending you to Nigeria? There were no seminaries there in Cameroon.
No, there was no English seminary.
Okay, no English.
Not English.
Okay, they were French.
It's almost so that that reunification. We were for reunification. As I remember,
yes,
Bishop Julius Peters, our bishop.
Okay. You knew Bishop Peter very well. You spoke with him, you knew him as a person.
Oh.
Bishop Peters, Julius Peters.
Of course. I knew his predecessor.
Bishop Rogan.
Rogan, he was the one who admitted me in Boya.
Interesting.
I was going to be a priest for Jos in the northern part of Nigeria.
Wow.
The civil war came, my parents and we left Nigeria, and that's how I became. I went to see Bishop Rogan.
Okay.
And he admitted me for good.
Interesting.
And then I was transferred from Ibadan to
Enugu.
Oh,
I see.
I studied philosophy in Ibadan.
I see.
Because I went to the minor seminary in Nebad.
Okay.
And that's where the Diocese of Charleston, the North,
yes,
was sending its seminarians.
I see.
That's how I knew Nebad.
Okay. That's quite interesting. So before you continue, I mean, what was the relationship between seminarian and bishop at the time? You knew Bishop Wogan, you knew Bishop Joseph Peters. What was the relationship? Was it cordial? Was it
between seminarians
and their bishop? You were a seminarian.
When I transferred from Jos to Boya, and when I went to see Bishop Rogan for the first time, he literally carried me on his lap.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Interesting. You were so very, very small at the time?
No, not so small.
So he was in charge. You're just trying to say he was very happy to see you.
Yes, I've always been tall.
Oh, really? From seminary days?
Oh, yes.
Interesting.
I was born tall.
I see.
You know, we come from Fubai.
Oh.
Our family.
Okay.
From my mother's side.
I see.
I remember when I was appointed bishop, I went to see the president, Amadou Ahidjo.
Oh.
And he spontaneous, are you from Fuma?
Okay.
I said, no, I'm from Bamsa.
Did he speak English?
No, no, I was
in French.
Yes.
Okay. Interesting.
No, I was already
fluent.
Presently, I was going to say when, concerning our seminary formation in Nigeria,
okay.
We went to Nigeria because there was no English speaking seminary in Cameroon. All the same, as deacons, there were four of us, myself, Peter Chu, Francis Basinge, and James Okika.
Oh.
And the bishop took us in this car, in Mercedes.
Interesting. In those days?
Quite, yeah. He was given that when he was made bishop.
Okay.
By his family, we were told. Okay. The bishop took us, he came to because there were doubts about his being ordained a deacon.
Okay.
So on the way, I asked the bishop, "My Lord, why do you continue to send us to Nigeria when there is a major seminary in Yamale?"
Okay. What was his answer?
He told me, "Christian, that's a political question." So we stopped there.
I see. You didn't ask any further. Okay.
Why did I add it? My aim was to learn French, to be bilingual like my country.
As a young priest.
I see.
You love your country.
Already, as a seminarian,
okay,
I would have loved that entrance. Because, you know, many priests here in the French speaking part of the country are bilingual.
That's true.
Because the bishop sent them to Bangui.
Oh, okay.
Yes, I admitted the first French-speaking seminarians in Bangui.
I see.
And they are all perfectly
bilingual. Yes.
You know, if we had taken that line to the bishop here, who has succeeded, was sending students to Bangui already.
Oh, that's good.
Wanted to have bilingual.
Bilingual priest.
Yes, so that's why. That's why when my bishop, 2 years after my ordination, or should I say 3 years, decided to send me for further studies in Europe.
Okay.
And he said that would go to him. I said, "My lord," when I told him, "My lord, I have something to say. What have you to say?"
Interesting. You told him.
He knew that I always ask questions.
Okay. Is it a good thing to do?
It was a matter of dialogue.
Oh, so that's good.
Computer speed. Maybe others were afraid. I was never afraid to ask my question.
Okay.
Always.
That's good. I like that.
So then, this time, he didn't hesitate. When I told him, "I have something to say," he said, "What are you doing?" I said, "I would like to study in a French speaking country."
What is the action?
Say, "All right, but I don't know where to send you." So I told him, "I would like to go to the Congo. There was uranium already in the Congo."
Interesting.
Run by the Jesuits.
I see.
From Belgium.
Okay.
So he said, "All right." So I was preparing to go to the Congo. When Mobutu closed down the university. And send all the students, Congolese students, for military service for 2 years. Because they had revolted on something.
Okay.
So they going to Kinshasa was out.
So they were worried.
But my bishop was a friend of Bishop Ndomo.
I see.
Bishop Ndomo comes to prayer.
Yes.
And he brought up the idea of my going to further studies. We are French speaking
country.
And as my bishop told me, I sent mine to Fribourg,
to Sabon?
No, to Lyons.
Ah, Lyon, in France.
In France.
Okay.
Let him go there. That is how I went to him, Lyons.
Can you imagine?
And I didn't know I had been trying to study some French, but I didn't go far.
Okay.
So I left Cameroon
in the 70s.
No, in the 60s.
Oh, because you were already in 1966.
Yes.
3 years after.
3 years after
69.
I was 69.
I see.
And I left in August.
Interesting. You remember the month?
Yes.
Why do you remember that month? Was it a special month for you?
No, it just like I remember that I had to study initially as in the French language for 3 months before the university starts.
Okay.
So I went to Paris, Alliance Française.
Okay.
Where I initiated myself in French. I was memorizing 50 new words in every day for 3 months. So, October, I enrolled in the University of Lyons. And it was not easy for me.
The language.
But I said, I am here.
Yeah.
One of the reasons I am here is
because of French.
Anyway, when I went for the orals at the end of the academic year,
yes,
one of the professors put down his book. He said, "You see, Rabbi, how did you do it? When you came here, you could not express yourself in French. Now you are dialoguing with me on philosophical and theological topics in French. Come on, Rule of Faith." So I told him I came here to struggle to learn French language also.
And
he was in my country's say, "You must be a brilliant fellow." So he gave me good notes and I went away.
That was wonderful.
So I admired that in a matter of just a few months, I could express myself in the French language.
While you were there, did anybody talk to you about Professor Fonlon?
No.
Okay, nobody.
They didn't know anybody.
Okay, I see. Did you communicate with Fonlon while you were in Europe?
Strangely, no.
Okay.
I didn't know.
I see.
But then I remember.
Yes.
When I got my doctorate degree in Fribourg.
Systematic theology.
Philosophy.
Oh, philosophy. Okay. You're a philosopher.
Yes, I
said for the truth.
I got a doctorate in philosophy. And I would have loved to do take a doctorate in theology.
Okay.
But I did not qualify for that. Because I did not know much Greek.
And Hebrew.
Yeah, especially Greek.
Okay.
I wanted to study the Greek fathers.
That's true. But you did not know the language. It was an obstacle.
Yes. So I dropped that and did philosophical thinking.
You're a good thinker. Almost everybody says that. Cardinal Tumi is a good thinker who is always out for the truth, and that's where a philosopher is. The philosopher asks questions to know the truth.
To blame my father. And that's where I mean the enemies of the government, the regimes.
Okay. Because you always say the truth.
Well, always blame. I'm not saying that I'm perfect.
Okay.
You know, it's difficult to satisfy someone who has a philosophical formation.
That's true.
Difficult to satisfy.
That's true.
But when I go to that place, they think I'm questioning the government.
That's unfortunate. It's not the objective way of looking at it.
Almost wherever I have gone,
yes,
I have been threatened by the government.
Oh my God.
When I was still in Bangui, we organized a meeting in 1975.
Yes.
In Birmingham Town Hall.
Okay.
And bribery and corruption.
Wow.
1975.
Can you imagine?
And thank God, the governor then, and Birmingham, a boy naturally.
Yes.
Was a brilliant young man.
Okay.
Perfectly by the way. I still admire that man today.
I see.
I would like to see if you are the president of this country. Is the one person who understands very well the Anglophone problem.